Horsetails is proudly brought to you by the South Carolina Department of Agriculture. South Carolina, a true leader in the equine industry.
Folks, we're in a beautiful community of Boykin, South Carolina, right outside of Camden. Me and Simpson's up here. We're going to be participating in the annual Spring Fling Trail Ride to benefit the South Carolina Thoroughbred Retirement Foundation, and also the Palmetto Pony Club is going to be here. So, folks, we're going to have a great time here today. It's beautiful. Richard had to kind of run me in. I've been riding around looking at these beautiful old barns and this house and stuff. So, folks, we're going to have a great day on the back of a horse. So stay tuned for some great horse tales. All my life, I've been obsessed with horses. I was curious and wanted to see other people's love for their horses and their stories. I'm David Grant, the PD Cowboy, and along with some incredible horse owners, I want to share the story of horses and the people that have a passion for them. Horse Tales is being brought to you today by Carolina Fresh Foods. Folks, we are Fresh Delicious. Equestrian Images, making memories together. By the South Carolina Horsemen's Council, the voice of the horse in South Carolina.
Andrews Mill Hay Farms.
And brought to you by Anderson Brothers Bank. Right car, right payment, right now. Treating you like family since 1933.
South Carolina's Market Bulletin has connected consumers and farmers for over 100 years. From ag news to meeting notices to free ads, you can count on the Market Bulletin.
South Carolina, it's a matter of taste.
Farmers are always planning for higher yields, more diversity, expanding opportunities. Nationwide and your local agent want to help your farm last through the generations. As the number one farm insurer in the country, Nationwide can help you achieve your goals. We stand for you.
Are you ready for a new ride? Anderson Brothers Bank has the right payment you've been looking for. If you enjoy a bank that gets to know you and your needs, then Anderson Brothers Bank needs to be your bank. Now is the time to stop by one of our 20 locations throughout the PD and coastal regions, where decisions are made locally. Right car, right payment, right now at Anderson Brothers Bank.
You can't always be there to protect her down the road. Make sure the tires she's riding on will. With the revolutionary Michelin Premier Tire, even as it wears down over time, its safety doesn't, thanks to EverGrip technology. The Michelin Premier Tire, safe when new, safe when worn.
Southern States carefully crafts every bag of Legends horse feed with the highest quality ingredients available. The Legends Superior line of specially formulated feeds will help keep your horses happy, healthy, and in peak form. You and your horse have a special bond. To keep that bond everlasting, Legends Horse Feeds can accommodate every type of nutritional need a horse might have. Legends, redefining what horse feed should be. Visit your local Southern States dealer to see which Legends feed is best for your horse.
Folks, joining me now is William Cox, the past chairman of the South Carolina Thoroughbred Retirement Foundation. Folks, that's a mouthful. And the incoming chairman, Judy Farrell.
Thank you.
It's good to be here.
I'm glad to have you.
William, so what's been going on? I know you've done a great job and going to be passing the gavel along to a very competent person. So what's been going on with you?
I'll tell you, I'm pleased to do it. I've been involved for a few years with this organization, and Judy is a wonderful successor. She's doing a great job. Her background is in marketing with in healthcare, and she loves horses. She loves thoroughbred, so it's a perfect fit.
Well, Judy, we were talking. You're from Kentucky.
I am. I grew up going to the Kentucky Derby. So
so you live in Sumter. So what brought you from Kentucky all the way to Sumter?
My husband's job, and we've lived there. And then I took a job here in Camden and got involved with the TRF, and I have had a ball working for them.
Well, you've taken the helm from an already successful organization.
Absolutely. Could not ask for a better successor.
So we've done a show in the past. We're going to probably let a little time pass and do that again. But
wonderful.
What's some things you look to be accomplishing?
Well, we want to increase the visibility of the South Carolina Thoroughbred Retirement Foundation. We do have 27 horses at the farm, and we are trying to get all of the adoptable ones to find permanent homes out in the community with riders who will take them on trail rides like this, hunt them, show them, do whatever with them. So mostly right now we're concentrating on increasing our visibility.
Now, what's some of the programs that's going on with the inmates out there?
We have the Second Chances Groom Elite Training Program, which is an extensive training program that works with the men in the prison and teaches them very high level groom skills so that they are capable of working in show barns, at the racetrack, at training facilities. They know an enormous amount about equine care.
When we did the show in the past with William, we was quite a many success stories with that in the forest.
Yeah, we had some wonderful times.
We really did. And I went to the websites and I read one last time. Some of the letters that some of the guys wrote was really heart-wrenching.
I mean, inspirational.
It really is. So, well, listen, how can folks, I know you need some donations or anything we can do to help out, right?
We would love to. If you will go to trfsc.org, we have a website. You can make donations. You can foster a horse. You can find out about adopting a horse. You can support us and you can learn what's going on. We're also on Facebook as well. So if you follow us on Facebook, we'll keep posted with updates of what's going on with all of our horses and our programs.
And last but not least, what's going on here today?
It's the Boykin Spring Fling Untimed Trail Ride. We're at Canty Lane Farm in the Boykin community.
Well, folks, we're going to canter right along because we're going to have a great time here today. Folks, joining now, Patricia Palm from Rembert, South Carolina. She's the commissioner of the Palmetto Pony Club.
That is correct.
What's got you at Canty Lane Farms today?
We are co-hosting the Boykin Spring Fling Trail Ride with the South Carolina Thoroughbred Retirement Foundation.
Right, and this is the first year you've had it in the spring. We were talking a while ago, it's a fall activity.
We've had this ride in the spring before. It started out as a fall timed hunter pace.
Right, and so what's going on? This little trail ride here has some activities, so what's going on today? What kind of activities?
Well, it's a at your pace trail ride.
Gotcha.
We have adults and children participating in the ride from various organizations. Some of them are with the IEA, which is the Interscholastic Equestrian Association, and some are with the Palmetto Pony Club, and then just others that enjoy trail riding.
Well, last night I was on internet. So tell us, folks, about the Palmetto Pony Club. It's pretty special. So what is the Palmetto Pony Club?
Palmetto Pony Club is a chartered chapter of the United States Pony Clubs of America, and we have been operating in this area since 1993.
Okay.
It was originally founded in Camden, and it serves Kershaw, Sumter, Lee County, and the metropolitan area of Columbia.
So how many, if I say this right, the chapters are in South Carolina?
We are in the Carolina region, which includes North and South Carolina, and we have 17 clubs in the two states.
Wow, and we were small talking, so there's one in Camden? It's King Street.
One in King Street, it's PD, is the name of their club.
So y'all have regular structured organized shows, is that correct?
Not shows. Ours is more of an educational program.
Okay.
Our club does mounted meetings monthly, and we also include unmounted meetings during those monthly meetings. The children that are participants learn to ride as well as learn horse management and how to care for their horses.
So from what age to what age can be in the Palmetto Pony Club?
We take them around the age of 4 up through 25 years of age. And there is a system of certifications that they are tested on per the standards of proficiency.
Okay.
And they will earn their standards or their certifications from D1 up through A.
Wow, so 4 years of age. I've got a granddaughter that's 20 months.
Oh, then you have something to look forward to.
Well, listen, I know there's going to be some folks out there that would love to get involved in this. How can I get in touch with you?
You can reach me. Best way to do that is via email, and the email address is pbpalm08@aol.com.
Well, thank you very much for your time, and we're going to ride on out here in a minute.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Have a great day.
Hi, my name is Mary Catherine Farnell, and I'm from Camden, South Carolina, and I'm here at the Boykin Spring Fling Trail Ride to benefit the South Carolina Thoroughbred Retirement Foundation. Meet my friend Lily Goat, and stay tuned for more Horse Tales.
Horse Tales is being brought to you today by Morrell Tire Service. Ride on in and see Richard and his fine family of technicians to take care of your automotive needs. Buy pieces for you and your home.
In these days of big corporate business, it's good to know there's a local bank that not only cares about you, but your community as well. Anderson Brothers Bank, corporate business minded with a heart for its customer and community.
You can't always be there to protect her down the road. Make sure the tires she's riding on will. With the revolutionary Michelin Premier Tire, even as it wears down over time, its safety doesn't, thanks to EverGrip technology. The Michelin Premier Tire, safe when new, safe when worn.
From barbecue sauce to Benny wafers, members of the South Carolina Specialty Foods Association have a wide array of products that are sure to be a hit at your kitchen table.
South Carolina agriculture, it's a matter of taste.
Carolina and Clemson haven't agreed on much since 1896. It's a healthy multi-sport rivalry. And this year, every head-to-head competition is part of the inaugural certified SC-grown Palmetto Series. So while Gamecocks and Tigers each support their team, we can all support local farmers by purchasing certified SC-grown products. Just look for the certified SC-grown label where you shop and follow your team at palmettoseries.com. It's a matter of taste.
Folks, old PD Cowboy got another tack tip for you. Folks, this is a shoe fly, like shoe fly. Now, it's debatable how much good it does, but it sure looks sporty. And I know you cowboys and cowgirls out there want to look sporty. If you've seen the old cowboy out and about, I usually keep a couple of them. I wear one on my pulling collar. And there is such thing as a shoe fly keeper on there, but old cowboy, I had to improvise. You know I keep zip ties everywhere I go, that and duct tape. So you can, and make sure it matches with the color, folks, you can match that. Looks sporty. All right, folks. Also, you can put one, this is my back cinch, and you hook it up to your front girth, and got your keeper there, and you keep one there, and I look sporty. Folks, they got them different sizes and stuff, but if you, I know when you're out and about, you want to look the part. I'm a wannabe cowboy, but that's my tack tip for today. Marsha, you know I don't trail ride a lot, but this has been some beautiful country today, hasn't it?
It's absolutely beautiful. And we are fortunate that they are allowing us to ride on this property.
For this spring fling ride at Canyon Lane Farm.
Yes.
An untimed event. So we're not having to keep score, right?
Right. We're just riding at our own pace. And see, I told you you would like trail riding once you got started doing it.
Well, we're just talking about thoroughbreds and how important the thoroughbred industry is to the economy here in South Carolina. So I know you're very involved in that. What's going on with the thoroughbred industry?
Well, lots of racing. One of my missions or goals is to kind of unite the thoroughbred industry and have them cross-promote races. Aiken, Camden, Charleston, King Street, Ellery all have great races. And if they all cross-promote each other, then that builds support for the sport as a whole. And it gives the fans something to look forward to.
Well, like I say, like we say it all the time, how important that the equine is to the economy in South Carolina, and like here in Camden, it's just beautiful. But I'm just taken aback. I met William Cox. We did a show with the Thoroughbred Retirement Association. They're coming out to this event, and we got a new commissioner, I think, mm-hmm. and we'll be working with her. So we're going to have to do some of this again. It's just gorgeous out here.
Oh, it's beautiful. And there's so many organized trail rides throughout the spring and fall, which is what I love doing as much as anything else. And I don't know if you know, David, but I used to ride thoroughbreds. I galloped racehorses up in Southern Pines when I was back in college, and I owned a few thoroughbreds. So they are very dear to my heart, and I really want to promote the thoroughbred industry, the racing industry, because it's so huge. I was talking to somebody the other day who said, who moved here from Kentucky. She said, I felt like I moved into a horse wasteland because people don't know what a valuable commodity horses are here.
Well, we do.
Yes,
folks,
we do.
That's an interesting tidbit of information. You used to gallop racehorses.
I did, in Southern Pines.
Well, let's just gallop on down the lane.
Okay, well, this is not a thoroughbred, and he's not a good galloper, but we'll give it a go.
Well, we got the state horse, Damaris Tacky, the spotted saddle horse, walking horse, and a thoroughbred. So, folks, thoroughbreds, especially if you're looking for a good retired thoroughbred, he's done great on the trails today. Isn't that right, Charlotte?
Perfect.
Well, let's ride on. Folks, that's what it's all about today on this trail ride. New friends, old friends. And joining me now is Mary Foster Cox and her daughter, Callie. Their dad is William Cox. So, y'all enjoyed the trail ride today?
It was awesome. It was a beautiful day out there. Ooh, goodness.
So, y'all did the 10-mile loop?
Yes, sir.
Well, that's nothing for you, isn't it?
No.
Well, listen, found out that y'all ride out of Boxton Farms, Linda Klein, right?
Yeah, we sure do. We sure do.
So this is a family. Tell us a little bit about your experience in the Palmetto Pony Club.
Well, we've just joined this year, and the Palmetto Pony Club has just started going again, and we've got lots of kids and parents involved. The kids are mostly at different levels, so we have young kids up through teenagers, and the parents help with the rides and help get the horses ready, and it's just been great for us. Super learning experience for Callie.
Well, Callie, when I met your dad for the first time, we were talking about doing a show with the Thoroughbred Retirement Association. He said, my daughter rides. I said, well, I want to meet her and do some interviews. So how long you been riding?
I've been riding since I was 4 years old.
And you how old now?
I'm 11.
Okay, so what, old cowboy don't know a lot about English riding, so what level or stage are you?
I jump 2, 3, maybe.
And you just started riding this horse, is that correct?
Yes, sir. It's been about the 7th time I've ever ridden him.
I asked your dad, I said, William, you ride? He said, well, I used to. He said, now I just work so that my wife and daughter can ride. You got a good dad. Well, listen, let's get in a little bit more riding. You want to? Let's go.
Let's go.
Hi, my name is Jody Fate. If you couldn't tell by my accent, I'm from Norfolk, England, but now I live in Sumter, South Carolina. Stay tuned for more Horse Tales.
Horse Tales is being brought to you today by King Street Auction Company, the leading auction company in the Southeast.
And by Mark Hausman, the Mark Hausman Training Center.
By the South Carolina Agriculture Department, it's a matter of taste. Folks, often heard, take care of your trailer tires. But folks, the old PD Cowboys getting ready to go on a trip to Fusky Island. I knew I needed two new tires. The other ones on the other side looked pretty good. So I went on with my good friend, Richard Morrell, Morrell Tire Service in Lytle, South Carolina. He said, well, David, definitely need two. Then he told me something I didn't know. It was a DAP number. It shows the dates of the tires. And because I knew I didn't have any dry rot because I was that smart. Old cowboy has a little bit of horse sense. And he said, David, that tire's 11 years old. I said, what? He said, yeah. He said, and old Richard's been at it a while, folks. He said he recommends 7 years. So I know most of us horse folks are on a budget. But, folks, you do not want to be broke down beside the interstate, especially a lot of my viewers out there are women. And I know, girls, you hook up and go, but do not ever, ever just assume because the trailer tire looks good and you don't see dry rot it is, check them. Better yet, have a professional like Richard Morrell at Morrell Tire Service. Folks, with Richard, I am going to give him another plug. He is a great sponsor. Drive a little, save a lot. Richard, when I left there, I felt like I was in a brand new rig. But folks, I tell you, went to Arkansas with a good friend, Marion Brooks. He had a trailer that was 5 years old. Bought it new off the lot. Brand new tires. And folks, before we got back from Arkansas, we had blown four of those tires and two more used ones. So folks, I'm going to tell you, I carry two extra spares when I go out and about, and you know what kind of jack I've got from the last time we did this trailer tip. So folks, I am the PD Cowboy. I endorse this safety tip. You best beware. folks. I got Porter Laney here with me, and it's a small world. Mm-hmm. All y'all know that I love to hog hunt, and her granddaddy is Alan Wooten. We was a little joke between me and Alan. I'm the PD cowboy, and he's off the Watery River. Long ago, these two old bulls said, "Hey, you stay on the PD, I stay on the Watery." Well, listen, it was a treat meeting you. Tell me about what you've been doing today.
I've been having a great time trail riding and jumping over some jumps.
So you're a member of the Palmetto Pony Club, right?
Yes, sir.
And how long have you been riding?
About 7 years.
Well, folks, I asked her that a while ago. I said, you were born riding? So you're how old now?
I'm 12.
You're 12?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So where do you go to school?
Thomas Sumter Academy.
Okay. Do y'all have an equestrian team there?
We do, and I just started. I'm in the sixth grade.
Wow. Well, that's great. Well, what have you learned by being part of the Palmetto Pony Club? What has it taught you?
I know much more than I did before, from tying a horse to the trailer.
Right. Well, does your parents ride? How did you find out your love for horses?
My mama, whenever she was little, she rode and had some horses, and I loved them.
Well, I've often said to everybody that because of the horse, my life has stayed on the course, and I kind of think yours has too, hasn't it?
Yes, sir.
Well, let's ease on down this lane and get us something to eat. You want to?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Folks, riding down that lane, all the books I read growing up, Flicka, My Little Red Pony, The Black Stallion, and having these young ladies right here, this is very special. And look who I found, Cortina Hutto with Tally Ho. Cortina, what are you doing here today?
We're trail riding. We're out having fun today.
Yeah.
Just trying to have a good time. We've been horse showing every weekend, and it's a chance to get the girls and their horses out. And we're supporting the TRF, which is a great cause, and Pony Club.
Well, good. Yeah. Well, we've done several shows out there with Bethlehem Therapeutic Riding, one of my favorite places, and today, I think y'all just gonna relax and wine. You need that, don't you?
I do.
Well, you got your group here, right?
Yeah, a bunch of my Tally Ho girls and kids on my IEA team and on the Pony Club. So I got a bunch of kids.
Well, you got it going on out at Tally Ho. How can folks get in touch with you?
Just look on our website, tallyhoequestriancenter.com, or call me myself. That'd be great.
And folks, the old PD Cowboy loves to hang around out there with the therapeutic riding, so you can look at me things. All right, girls, what are we gonna say? 1, 2, 3,
Tally Ho!
Folks, just a great day up here at Canny Lane Farm, Boykin, South Carolina. This farm has been in this family for 300 years, folks. Just when Revolutionary War days, just amazing. And some of these oak trees here, I can't say just how majestic they are. Folks, today, South Carolina Thoroughbred Retirement Foundation, Palmetto Pony Club, put on a good shindig. I hadn't eaten yet, but I'm getting ready to get me some good old barbecue chicken. And folks, like I say, it's what it's all about. Horses, good times, and good South Carolinian. Folks, like I say, behind you is a beautiful oak tree, and right here is a whale. I'm just looking at a whale. There's no telling who has rode up to that whale through the years, folks. And until next week, I wish you well, and keep your reins low and your hands quiet, and God has blessed this great country of ours.